Hi, I'm Mayuri, head interior designer at Spaces of You. And at Spaces of You, we design homes, we do turnkey projects, we do projects that involve a makeover. Today, I'm back with SOH Handmade series, where we're going to be talking about DIYs, which are easy to do, hacks that can be done in a jiffy, and make your home thrifty, nifty, and beautiful. Hey guys, welcome back to Spaces of You. Today we are back with another video which is around a DIY, a simple, easy to do DIY which you can literally do in your home in like 5 to 10 minutes. And it is for the festive season primarily. So I'm really happy to share this with you. And I definitely want to, focus on this bit that, you know, when we come together on festivals, food is what really brings us together. And that reminds me of, you know, setting your dinner tables, your dining tables beautifully when your guests arrive. So the DIY today that we're going to talk about is doing some really cool napkin rings. I know a lot of you love these beautiful collection of napkin rings that we go through the Pinterest feed or your Instagram feed. And so many times I see these really pretty napkins placed almost like a sidekick when they can be the focal point. And I think napkin rings are the way to go. How you can create that bejeweled theme for your napkins, or just give them a bit of that push that they need to become the focal point of your table, your plate settings. So let's dive into them. So for the first DIY, all we need is a copper wire. You can go for any other colored wire, or maybe like a black wire depending upon the color of your napkin. But I'm going to be taking here a bit of interesting patterned napkin over here like this. So I'm taking this napkin over here, and what we're going to do essentially is place it like this and make it into a three-fold, like a small little roll. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to hold the bottom of the wire over here, and I'm going to take it like this. Just ensure that you are able to get through your napkin through the ring which you're making. You basically make about 4 to 5 rolls like this. You can also make something which is crisscrossy, but I'm going to go for a very simple napkin ring over here, right? And then you just bring the ends together like this and just tuck them in. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to make this napkin like this, and I'm going to push it through this like this. There you go. This is such an easy napkin ring, that you can make and place in the center of your plate, and your guests will love it. It's a really cute shiny piece. Even if you don't have a metallic shade like golden or copper cutlery on the side, this will still look very pretty, and it has these really nice copper feel, you know, wire which can kind of come out when your guests want to just use the napkin. So this is really that simple, and yeah, makes it super easy to make, like literally in a minute. So you can make 6, 7, 8 depending upon your own table setting, how many, you know, how big or large is your table. You can make 8 or 9 of them in literally 10 minutes. You don't need a lot of it, so it's an easy way to do it. It's super cool, easy table napkin ring that you can use for this festive season. We'll talk about the next one now. For this DIY, we need a smaller piece of, say, about 4 to 5 inches of a copper wire or any wire that you have, a few colorful beads that will shine through the type of napkin you're using, and a bit of this floral tape that I tend to use to soften the base of the napkin ring over here. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to put these bejeweled beads through the copper wire here like this, and another one just to emphasize. They are really beautiful green, they almost look like semi-precious stones. So really pretty beads that I was able to pick from Itsy Bitsy, I guess. All right, so this is almost in the center now. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to try and put the beads, the black beads from the side. Right, and I'm just going to see how big a napkin ring will I need it for this fanned napkin. So I'm just going to fold it like how you fold a pleat, right? You're just going to do that. I want the fanning bit to be a bit more, like this. Now we're going to just put this like this, right? And try and see how much of, do we need more beads? I think we are good to go. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just put the beads in and just sort of knot it from the back. But to completely seal it, we're going to use a plier and cut off the excess of the wire like this. And use this floral tape in the back to just sort of make this into something simple and softer at the back, and then just tie it off. It's totally okay if it looks like a small little DIY. Your guests will definitely appreciate it, that you went the extra mile to do something sweet and nice for them, and which looks almost store-bought. So I'm going to just pull this over here, fan it out a little bit more. Yep, that's it. And you're done. You have this beautiful, pretty. It has some really cool custom colors. You can actually choose a color palette for your dinner table setting and then choose the beads that you want to. Of course, I've gone ahead with the emerald green background of my, the tablecloth that I'm using here, and I'm kind of picking the colors from there and I'm using it against this beautiful plate. But you can literally do any color that you love, any type of beads, make it more traditional, or you can even replace beads with something else like pearls and things like that. So it's literally your game. You can do whatever you like to. This is a really cool DIY that you can use in your next festive dinner, or any dinner party for that matter. I hope you like this one. We'll move on to the next one. Next DIY, we need a macrame thread or a piping thread you get online or in any tailor shops. Apart from that, you need some flowers, any flower you can choose, whatever that goes with your color scheme, your color palette, or just what is available at your home, and a fine comb. So the first thing that we will do is we need to just cut the thread to size so that you can tie basically a bow on top of it, and just tie the edges a bit like this, just one knot on the edges, just so that you can create a small tassel on the side like this. So you created two tassel kind of pieces over here. Just take a comb now and just comb this well so that you get like really nice fine tassels. Once you've done that, take a pair of scissors and just trim off the excess. This is ready. What you now need to do is just fold the napkin in a rectangular way, just how we place it typically. Place the flower over here like this and just take this from underneath like this. Now the most important part comes is, how do you want the knot to be? You want it to be a little difficult for your guests to pick up, then you can take it under the flower, right? Just take it once more under the flower like this and sort of string it together like this, right? Once you've strung it like this, then just create a small bow. How you can just simply create like a small, very rustic, very farmhousey looking napkin ring or napkin tie, if you will. If you want to keep it super easy, what you can do is just keep the same thing over here and just tie it from here. Like this also, totally simple, so that people can just remove the flower, keep it on the side and go on with their dinner lunch. whatever meal that they're having for the day. So it's a very easy to do floral napkin ring. You can use any flower. If you don't have real flowers and you have artificial ones, you can use them as well. They work perfectly fine, and they look as good. So this is the third one which we've shown you, and I hope you do like it. We look forward to your comments in this section. Thank you.